Hello, you beautiful people, and welcome back to another episode of TORQUAY UNITED Road to Glory Career Mode on my channel. First of all, I'm just slightly hungover right now. I went to a wedding, my head is currently banging at the moment, but that ain't gonna stop me taking TORQUAY to the absolute best, because to be honest with you, we're getting there. We're third place, just in the playoffs, but we're fighting for automatic promotion. I want to go higher. I want Wembley off the card, to be honest with you, because I don't want to go for that playoffs again, but that's depending really. And this squad is showing it. I've got the striker I need. The Scots are absolutely doing wonders for me. And to be honest, if you look at the squad straight away, you think, boom, promotion straight away, because it is a brilliant squad. But that is going to be the main goal of today's episode. Well, kind of, because I want to show you the debt. There's no Homer screen, and I'll tell you why. It's £500,000. 500k. So if we sell one player worth more than 500k, then boy oh boy, the debt is clear. And if next season, if we're promoted, we can spend some transfer fee on players. And with the window open, I am open to hear from offers. So first up, I did get a pre-contract, the Polish fast winger from Swansea. Placentia will be joining us next season, and afterwards I found this player on the free agents, and people think, whoa, what are you thinking? Yes, he's been in the news for some numerous things, and you think, is it a gamble bringing him to Torquay United? I can't see why not. And let me tell you, I don't see a problem with him failing a drugs test. Literally, look at Rio Ferdinand, he failed a drug test and he turned out well. So Jakub Jankov, well, the Czech Republican, joins the squad. Oh, he's gay. I don't see the problem with that at all. But the main quest is literally out of reach. Literally, it was going quiet. And I was getting scared that the debt won't be collected. Oh, for crying out loud. Even when I got an offer of one of my players, I tried to make it to 500k. And he's walking out the office. He said, no, I don't want to. And it was looking like we were never going to get rid of it during this transfer window. Until one email popped through. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Torquay United are debt-free. The debt is reached to zero, so that means in season number four, we can spend some transfer fees on players. Oh, I can't wait for that, but with the squad looking good, let's hope that season number four will be in the championship for the goals.
Was Carlisle away. We decided to put on pressure off him quite quickly as Kane went, hold my beer, but sadly no one was there to actually hold his beer as the keeper managed to save it. But at the corner though, it was worked fantastically, magical, just throwing a bit of haggis because the Scottish duo did it again as Morgan tucks it in nicely. Then the Carlisle defence tied to panic as soon as they see Troy Parrott on the ball. Game over, man, game over. Oh, it didn't matter if Carlisle did manage to get one goal back, because that was like a first aid plaster on a leak. And I'll tell you what, sooner or later, the pressure exploded. Absolutely goals galore, demolishing Carlisle. 6-1. What a start to be debt-free. Then we're on to the debt derby. Wait a minute. We're no longer in debt. Yeah, it's against Reading. We were showing not just our finance might, as well as our talent as well. As Morgan yet again being the sole deliverer, making up 1-0 against Reading. But Reading kind of got jealous of us real badly as their effort sent through Smith. But Park matched with a great save. But well, if we send through Parrott, you know the results were going to be pretty much simple. An easy tuck and through 2-0. Second half, and Park was living up to the potential. Great save after great save, keeping Reading offline. But don't worry, I'm not going to waste these chances, especially if you got Troy Parrott. Denied. Okay, take two. Troy Parrott, there we go, makes it 3-1. And I'm afraid to say, Reading, just like last time, the bills are piling up. Then we're on to promotion favourites Derby County, and I tell you what, it felt like a fencing match, as to both sides produced good shots, but the goalkeepers were matching up with better saves. Then Troy Parrott kind of got bored of it and decided to bring a steel chair into it back. Wham! Straight away, 1-0 to the goals. Then Scott was sent through as Wright seed the opportunity to make it 2, but a great save from the Derby goalkeeper. But don't worry, if you send Troy Parrott 1-1, of course he's going to... Well, joke's on you, Derby County. I won 1-0 in that game. Now it's on to Salford City. We've got to get results regarding the teams. I'll tell you what, hello, the stopwatch is back. Cool, when did I have that? I think it was St. Pauli days. Oh, that brings back the memories with the Kreuz kickers, especially Maximilian Bayer scoring goals for fun. Kind of remind me of this side with Troy Parrott. Well, he needs to do a lot of potential, but Troy Parrott, early chance. And there's the stopwatch finishing, getting an early chance. Can you hear me, Gary Neville? Nah, you can't. But that wasn't my only shot, as the Scottish midfielder grabbed a second, giving Salford a taste of their own medicine, a sick taste. But this medicine was actually working, getting them better, as they managed to pull one back. But it only lasted 5 minutes, as Kane delivered a tap-in for Tony, and afterwards, Troy Parrott gets himself a brace in that game. Now it's time to educate these smug pricks. Yes, Cambridge right here. And to be honest with you, they were on the front, but amazing defending, keeping it off the line and keeping Cambridge away. But Cambridge, being the smug pricks they are, learnt quickly as their defence was absolutely solid like a rock. But one over-the-top ball for Troy Parrott was enough to break and crumble. But what kind of shocked me though was a quick response from Cambridge, as George Thomas went up the other end and made it 1-1, kind of panicked in the other way. You know how hard it was to break their defence? So in the second half we needed to get those goals, and afterwards Wright sees Tony and he delivers it right here for us. Stand and delivered from the English midfield, but Wright, he was getting himself a second assist of the game, crossed in, and it's only into the DAC to make it 3-1 against Cambridge at Plainmoor. Our final game was against Sheffield Wednesday, and Wednesday were out for blood, especially since last year in the playoffs. But then again, we got Troy Parrott, and Troy Parrott does what Troy Parrott does. Gets himself a goal for us. Wazzy Kazari would have gone to get Sheffield Wednesday back in this, but a great save. Park being himself a hero today. And speaking of Superman performance right here, Tony only got himself a bloody hat-trick, especially a long-range beauty to seal the cherry on top for Sheffield Wednesday. That's ending the match highlights. Let's go to the live
look
game.
At that table. It's looking good. It's looking juicy. We're second place, 10 points clear of third place. And with four games remaining, we could seal it for the goals. Promotion into the championship. And what we got to do is get a win. That champagne is coming right out.
I may be recovering from a hangover, but a few champagne glasses celebrating Torquay United's promotion push is absolutely worth it. So, our next game is against Lincoln City. It doesn't really matter if we get the game sealed today because we've got other games in hand, but I would love to get it done as soon as possible. You see the starting 11, it's the strongest as possible. We're going full guns blazing, get the goals, get the win, and championship for season number 4. It's only here, it's only now, a way to seal it for the goals. Come on, Torquay United.
We see playing nice from the back. We've got a young defensive line. And they're only going to get better with age now. Troy Parrott, though, he's already better than he is. You know how many goals he's scored already. Sees the chance right here. Plays it across to Tony. Tony through balls it to Kirk. Kirk lays it across to his Scottish companion, Scott Wright, to make it 1-0 to Torquay United. Look at the scoreboard, 1-0, 5 minutes in. Pressure, what pressure?
Morgan heads it down into, well, Jackson right here, through balls it to Tony. Tony trying to find space. Kane's by himself, and you know what I'm going to do, twist it. Lays it across, Kane likes to go for him, but keeper managed to save it. Ever since his first long-range banter, that's what I've been doing with him, trying to get a long-range shot with him. Through ball into Hamilton now, who's got the ball nicely. Now plays it across, 1-2. Right, let's try and do something. Oh no, through ball's it. It's going to be 1-1, but the core. Oh, skin for chinny chin chin. So they've managed to miss that one. Kane on the ball, through ball's it to Tony. Tony plays it across to Kirk.
Now, he's got so many players around him, but you know what I'm going to do? Back again, slide tackle in, should be a foul. Kane's going to go for it. Maybe I should stop going for long shots with Kane. Yellow card for that earlier foul. I think it's just going to be a goal kick, though, because I took the shot way too early. And to be honest with you, it does look like that we're going to get something out of this game. Look, we're going to keep on the pressure. You can see Tony literally trying to draw the players away, and literally it's worked well. Through ball, lovely. Scott Wright gets himself a brace. He beats the defenders, outruns them, and the Scotsman does it again for us. It's 2-0 to Torquay United. Morgan, lovely control right here. Sly tackled. To be fair, he did get the ball, so I can't really complain too much right here as well. Look at him go now. They're going to get a chance before the half. That'll be absolutely breaking. No. We don't want to get him back in this game. And a goal before the half could do that, but Park made a great save. Rebound in, and Glover was able to get rid of it. Park's got a goal kick right here, and he's going to play it short. Second half, we need to start going for it as Finch plays it across to Leons. Yeah, the youth academy is doing wonders right here, getting some good scouts right here as Kane now through balls. Here we go, into Kirk, great run, fantastic, going to go for it. No, he's done the most unselfish thing. He sees his Scottish companion, Lewis Morgan, the other winger, and it's 3-0, showing that we definitely deserve promotion out of this league. Lincoln feeling like they got to get something out of this game. To be honest with you, they're really not really fighting for much. Well, we've got the urge of getting promoted right here. Lewis Morgan, give me the ball. Plays across to Troy Barrett. He's been quiet in this game, but not as quiet as this guy. Scott Wright gets his hat trick. Ah, oh, beautiful. It's been a Scottish fest here at Lincoln. Goals galore for the Scottish international. 4-0. We're literally better than the rest, and we deserve that promotion now. Now, Hamilton through balls is a hackle right here. 81st minute, I'm literally got no care in the world. Walker, back heel, what a back heel. Great save from Park, though. Oh, I'm going to include that. Literally, that's a beautiful way to get themselves back in this, but it's not going to happen. I'd love to keep a clean sheet right here. All right, we can see Corn's going to take a short right here. Smith through balls at Hamilton, twist, turns. Well, there goes that clean sheet. That annoys me a bit because you like to get a clean sheet on the day, but it doesn't really matter. Because no matter what, referee blows full time, and that is guaranteed. Torquay United will be playing in the championship in our fourth season. Huge work, and to be honest with you, we deserved it. Absolutely deserved it. I don't want to go through the playoff route. No. We're going up automatically, and I can't wait for next season what this potential squad has got. So, sadly, we did not be able to win the title. We did finish second. Ipswich and us are both on 100 points, by the way. But they've got a game in hand, and they're currently in first place. So, the title is out of reach. We're not going to go for it. But I don't care. They can keep the title as a consolation prize. I'm going to get promoted either way. And even though I've recovered from a hangover, I'm getting the champagne glass out. So, let me just run through the top goal scorers of the season. We've got Troy Parrott, of course, with 23 goals. Lewis Morgan's got 20 goals. 15 goals for Tony. 10 for Dak. And with the most assists is Kirk with 14. Tony with 13, tied with Scott. And afterwards, Troy Parrott's got himself 11. Wow, what can I say about this squad? It's absolutely amazing. Player of the season, I'll be honest with you. It's the hardest decision that's come across. So hard to come across a player this season. So many players deserve it. Literally, Tony, Parrott, Scott Wright, just Kirk, so many more. But I think Lewis Morgan deserves it. I think he's been a really good replacement from Eliza Just, and it shows it right here. He's been getting the goals, love and life here down the South Coast, and deserves player of the season. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is ending our third season. Promotion secured, championship awaits for the goals, and with the debt removed, we can spend some moolah. Hope you look forward to next season. I certainly am. And as always, subscribe to the channel for more career mode content. I'll see you lot later.